A South Carolina family is suing their travel operator over claims of false advertising and emotional distress. The Campbell family, including mother Sherry, dad Jim, and children Madison and Kit, have just returned from what they say was a disastrous 2 weeks in Europe. We spoke to the Campbells in their charming Clemson home. Mom Sherry explains what happened.
We first flew to London, England. I'm English, you see. My great-great-great-grandmother was born just outside of London in a city called Wales, so I've always wanted to return to the home country. I grew up watching all their TV shows, like Murder, She Wrote, so I just feel that connection. Well, that feeling quickly went away. We went for breakfast in the hotel restaurant. I asked for an iced tea, and the waitress just looked at me like I was speaking a different language. So I said it slowly. Iced tea. And you know what she brought me? A cup of tea with some ice cubes in it. I wanted to speak to the manager, but Jim told me to leave it. I couldn't find iced tea anywhere in England, not even in the cafe in Buckingham Palace.
Things only got worse when the family moved on to Paris. Husband Jim takes over the story.
After a week in England, we wanted some proper food, so we went to McDonald's, but they wouldn't accept my Discover card. And you know what? The guy serving said, "I guess you just discovered you're not in America," but in that French accent I could barely understand. So I took out my wallet and he laughed when I tried to pay with dollars. And people were staring at us, like we were in the wrong. I told him, "These are American dollars, son." And you know what he said? "This is not America, sir, please pay in euros or leave." So we left. We don't need that kind of treatment.
Dad, you're so embarrassing. God, I can't even. He's always making a scene.
Hush, Madison. And Paris is so boring. Like that Eiffel Tower or whatever. We saw that in Vegas when we took the kids there for spring break. And to be honest, the one in Vegas looks better, and there were so many of those foreigners hanging around in Paris. Let me tell you, we did not feel safe. Nobody was speaking English.
Right? And it was the same in Spain. Nobody spoke English there. Of course, we'd learned our lesson, so we exchanged some of our dollars for their money. But I couldn't do the math in my head. When we went to a restaurant and it said that a burger and fries cost 15 euros, I didn't know if that was more or less than $15 in American money.
Mom, I kept telling you that $1 and 1 euro are almost the same. Why do you always have to be like that? Rohypnol's mom is never like that. Even Jackson's mom isn't like that, and she's nuts.
Our final stop was in Dublin, because Jim is Irish. So we thought that because they speak English there, they'd use the same money as in England. But they used the same money as in Spain? How does that work? I just don't get Europe. And they did not like us one bit, did they, Jim?
I don't get it, Sherry. I wore my God Save the Queen t-shirt especially. And I wanted to buy some suspenders with that English flag on them, so I asked someone where I could buy suspenders, and he sent me to a sex shop. My goddamn children were there. Why would he do that? So on the plane back from Ireland, where, let me tell you, they do not speak English. We could not understand a single word anybody said to us the whole time we were there. Anyway, on the plane back, me and Sherry decided we're gonna sue Clemson World Travel. It was the worst 2 weeks of my life. Apart from when Sherry's mom visited us from Wisconsin, but that's another story.
We reached out to Clemson World Travel, who told us that they had no comment. We'll bring you an update on this story as details become available.